Chemistry life hacks, MacGyver meets Mendeleev, and these everyday chemistry-inspired tricks to make your life a little easier with all the evidence you need to back it up. Now let's get started. So what's for breakfast? Eggs. That's right, it's omelet time. The only problem is you can't remember the last time you actually cooked for yourself, and your carton of eggs has been tucked away in the back of your fridge for who knows how long. Last thing you want to do is stink up the place cracking open a rotten egg. So here's what you do. Fill a large glass container with water and drop in your eggs. If they're good to go, they'll stay at the bottom, and if they've gone bad, they'll float right to the top. Eggshells are actually very porous to allow a little breathing room for developing chicks. These pores also act as an entrance to bacteria, which cause the egg to begin decaying from the inside. This in turn produces a particularly stinky gas, hydrogen sulfide. The buildup of this gas inside the egg over time gives it its buoyant cue that you should probably go to the store and buy some fresh ones. You know the deal, the second your knife cuts through an onion, the waterworks start flowing. Nothing seems to be able to stop it, but we've got a trick for you that will keep your eyes dry. But first, a little bit about the chain of events that brings the fire to your eyes in the first place. Onions contain compounds called amino acid sulfoxides. Every knife stroke into an onion pops open cells, releasing these amino acid sulfoxides and other enzymes to produce a compound called sulfenic acid. The sulfenic acid and the onion enzymes then react to form sympropanethyl S-oxide. This is a compound that sends a fiery message into the nerve centers of your eyes, which then calls on your body's fire department to wash the irritant away with tears. Now, you can't stop this process completely, but keep this in mind. Refrigerate your onions before cutting them. The cold can reduce the tendency of the onion to release some of those volatile compounds that start the waterworks. You're running late for a date and you're putting on your favorite lucky shirt when you realize you accidentally popped the top button off. With anxiety building and the clock ticking, you try to sew it back on, but your shaky hands can't manage to thread the needle. When all the forces of the universe seem to be working against you, here's a quick tip to get you back on track. Take the frayed end of your thread and dip it into some clear nail polish. When the polish dries, you'll have a perfectly pointed thread that will effortlessly slip itself into position. Nail polish is a lacquer that is typically made out of nitrocellulose dissolved in a solvent, usually either butyl acetate or ethyl acetate. When that solvent evaporates, the nitrocellulose forms a film over whatever surface it's on. Some nail polishes also include resins such as tosylamide formaldehyde to give the polish a little extra body, and also have plasticizers such as camphor to give it a little more flexibility. That comes in handy when you're threading your needle. Get rid of the frayed edges of your thread to get rid of your frayed nerves and enjoy that date. You're trying to impress your guests at an upcoming dinner party, but you can't seem to get your veggies right. Every time you cook green vegetables, they turn into a nasty mush green. Well, here's a quick tip to stop your dish from turning into a Frankenstein veggie platter. First of all, it's important to know where the green comes from, chlorophyll A and B. Chlorophyll A is responsible for the bright blue green of some veggies, whereas chlorophyll B is responsible for the yellow green. At the center of these two molecules is a magnesium atom, which keeps the veggies a vibrant green. When they're heated, the vegetable cells are broken down and release acid, which is otherwise kept separate from living cells housing chlorophyll. The acids will quickly replace the magnesium with hydrogen, turning your veggies from vibrant to sludge green. So here's a golden rule to keep a vibrant veggie. Keep your cook time to 7 minutes or less. By limiting the cook time, you'll limit the amount of cell damage and preserve the color. Well, folks, thanks for watching the second installment of Chemistry Life Hacks. If you have any hacks of your own, send them over and we'll try to include them in future videos. And in the meantime, hit the subscribe button and we'll see you again soon.